This is Coop from GarageGymReviews.com, and today I'm gonna tell you about this. This is the Eleiko Öppen Deadlift Bar. This is Eleiko's latest offering, which is a trap bar with an open end design. It also has a couple other unique features like barbell-like handles, a jack feature, and then some other unique things that make it unlike any other trap bar that's out there. Let's get into it. Okay, so the Eleiko Öppen Deadlift Bar, I don't know why they came up with the name Öppen Deadlift Bar, maybe to separate them from their competition, but it's essentially a trap bar slash hex bar with an open end design. This is not the first trap bar with an open design. There's a couple of others that are out there. The first one I saw, I think, was by York, and it's not something I would ever suggest somebody use. It doesn't hold a lot of weight, but it does have a unique open design. The next one I saw is from InTech, and they have a couple of them, and I've used them. Both of those are good bars, there's no doubt about it, but those are the first open deadlift bars or open trap bars that I think got some popularity. And here's the reason for an open trap bar. It's not just like some novelty act, it actually works, okay? The difference between this and a traditional trap bar is this one you can do a few more movements with. So a few more movements that you can do are lunges, carries are a little bit easier, tricep extensions, a few things like that. But largely, you know, are you gonna do a lot of those things? Well, that's up to you. However, I think for a garage gym owner, having a bar that can do a wide variety of things for your training in a small amount of package is definitely something you should be looking for. Okay, so it provides that. The open design is what they call it. They call it the open deadlift bar because that's kind of a remarkable feature, but it's not the most remarkable feature in my opinion. I think they've got a lot of different things that add up to a great product. The second thing is the jack. So it's got a built-in jack. Think of like a deadlift bar jack that you used to prop the bar up and then you can put the plates on. This bar has one built in. So on the bottom, they have these rubber stoppers. You basically have it flat, you jack it up or prop it up, you put the plates on, there's space between the plates and the ground, and then you put it down and lift, okay? This is an awesome feature, no doubt about it. I think we've kind of become accustomed to it because there's a lot of companies that have come out with them recently. However, this is the only company that I know of that's selling a trap bar currently that you can buy as of this video that has this feature, okay? They were the first ones to come to market with it. Now there's other companies that have kind of like shown them, and we've shown them on our Instagram profile, companies like Kabuki Strength, Prime Fitness, ATX Power, and I think a couple other companies that have shown them, but this is the first one that you can actually buy. Moving up the bar, you have the handles, and this is really, I think, one of the best features of the bar is the barbell handles that are used. So rather than there just being some like cheap oversized 1.25 inch pipe with some crappy over-aggressive knurling, Eleiko did what, you know, they typically do is they take their barbells. They've got these world-class barbells that are some of the most well-liked barbells in the history of strength training. And they've basically taken them, chopped them off, knurled them in a way so that you can center your handle and then put them on the bar, okay? So use a 28 millimeter bar. I think the knurling is most similar to that of their competition power bar. I think it's known as a 2.0. I think it's the barbell knurling. They have two, 1.5 and one. A two is for their competition IWF, IPF type bars. The 1.5 is used for their like training bars, and then 1.0 is used for like their CrossFit bars, as far as I understand it, okay? So it's an aggressive knurl, but it's not overly aggressive. Comparing this to our other favorite trap bar, the TB2, that by the way, this blows the water out of, that TB2 from Rogue has way too aggressive knurling. We've had to sand it down and it still doesn't feel good. So this is a happy medium. It's aggressive, but not so aggressive that it just rips your calluses off. Big fan of this knurl. One part of the bar that I wasn't sure what they were gonna do with is the sleeves. So in order to ship this, you need a big box, okay? Whether you decide to ship it with the sleeves on or off, but Eleiko, which is a smart move for shipping to lower the cost, is they actually have removable sleeves that are used, that use stainless steel bolts to keep them together. It's a great idea, it works extremely well. I wasn't sure if it was gonna like impact the use. It doesn't at all. It feels as rigid as something being welded on. One other feature I wanna say about this that I think Eleiko may have overlooked, and I think really increases the versatility of the bar, and that is making the bar into a camber squat bar. okay? This bar works extremely well as a cambered squat bar. I thought it may be like, okay, it'll work, but no. It works just as good as any other cambered squat bar. It has this big bar up top that feels very comfortable on your shoulders, similar to like the crossbar on a yoke. I would like it if it was knurled in some way. Really, I don't even think they thought about this, but if it was knurled in some way, because this is a very slick part of the bar, I think it would be awesome. That said, you can use it easily as a cambered squat bar by holding the handles or wrapping your hands around the bar like you would a yoke. Again, another great feature that is thankful to the open end design, and it's rackable, okay? So you're able to rack it for rack deadlifts or like cambered squats or presses or whatever you want to use it for. It's rackable, works well. You can use this for bench press as a multi-grip bar. You can use it for tricep extensions, all sorts of things that you can't use a traditional trap bar for. Now, lastly, I want to discuss the price because this is an expensive bar. I think it's around, can you look up the price of the bar, Chance? I think it's $6.99.
A few moments later.
Okay, $7.99. Okay, so this is an expensive bar, no doubt about it. This will be one of the most expensive specialty bars you buy. This is even more than, say, a Duffalo bar. It's $799, okay? That's a little hard pill to swallow, no doubt about it. Yes, it's an Eleiko, so it's super high quality. You know, I mean, everything about it is high class, okay? It's a simple design that does a lot. Eleiko just knows how to build these things and does a really good job, but they also do not know how to price themselves, so it's kind of an elite bar, okay? For most people, that's gonna be too expensive. Is it worth the cost? I think it's worth the cost if you like the best of things, like a nice fit and finish, and plan to use the bar a lot. If you're not gonna use the bar a lot, then $7.99, I think that could be better spent elsewhere. This is also something I think commercial gyms and people outside of garage gyms could have interest in. It just works extremely well. It looks really good. It hides away really well. It doesn't take a lot of space because you can leave it standing. It's just a nice bar. But we do have to consider, you have a couple options coming out. The Kabuki Strength Trap Bar, which we leaked, looks like an awesome bar that's gonna, you know, has a lot of features that this has with a few additional. Then you have the Prime Fitness Trap Bar. You have ATX Power. I wouldn't be surprised if Rogue, Fringe Sport, all these other companies, Rep Fitness, came out with trap bars with open-end designs because it's just a really functional, useful design. And they're probably gonna be at prices lower than this. So something to consider. That said, if you want the best trap bar that's available right now and aren't worried about price, this is it. This is the best trap bar that you can buy today without money. I wouldn't say it's the best value because it is pretty expensive, but just if we're just talking best of the best, money is an issue, you want this bar. It's incredible. Thanks for watching. This is Coop from GarageGymReviews.com. Is $7.99? Is $7.99 too much to swallow? Let me know in the comments. See you next time. Peace. This intermission is brought to you by LaCroix. No, I'm not sponsored, I just like it. I'm just taking this second to tell you to subscribe. If you haven't subscribed yet, you should do so. Carry on.